Hi everyone, today let's discuss about lambda expression and its syntax. So this lambda expression concept introduced in Java 8, we can say this is the best features came as part of JDK 8, right? So as usual, let's understand from very basic. So first here we should know what is lambda expression and what is the need of this lambda expression, okay? So what is lambda expression, guys? The expression through which we can represent an anonymous function. Hope you heard the term called anonymous, right? Anonymous means nameless, or we can say unknown. Like the function or the method who don't have any name or who don't have any prefix is called as anonymous function. So using lambda expression, we can convert our abstract method to anonymous function. So let me show you one example of it. So this M1 is our normal traditional method, and this is what the anonymous method. And if you observe here, this parameter don't have any method name or don't have any prefix, right? So we can say this is the anonymous function. So now you might have question, if this method don't have any name or prefix, how we can call this method? So if you observe line number 16, we can able to call the M1 method, as we know the method name and we know the return type and we know the modifier, right? So we can't call this method. As we don't know anything about the method name or prefix, we can call this anonymous function. So here one thing we confirmed, like for every method we can't write the lambda expression. The lambda expression only can be applicable for functional interface. The method which is present in the functional interface, for that particular method only we can write the lambda expression. So here, before going forward to understand what exactly this lambda expression, first we should know what is the functional interface. Then we will get to know for functional interface how we can write the lambda expression, right? So first let me explain you what is the functional interface, guys. So the interface who contains only one abstract method, but it can have multiple default and static method, it's called functional interface, right? So as we know, in Java 8, inside interface we can write a default method and we can write a static method. But if that interface contains only one abstract method, then we can say that interface as functional interface. So if you observe in Java, runnable, callable, comparable and comparator, these four are the functional interface, as those interface contains only one method, right? So if you observe in runnable, we have the run method. Similarly in callable, we have call method, and in comparable, we have the compare to. Similarly in comparator, we have compare method, right? So that's why we can say each interface as functional interface. So let me show you source code of any of one interface. Let me go to the Eclipse. So this is what our runnable interface, go inside. Here if you observe, we have the annotation @ functional interface, and it contains only one abstract method, that is the run, right? So we can say this runnable is functional interface. Similarly, we can write our own functional interface. Let me show you that. As you understood, this is what my abstract method, and I have two default method and I have one static method. It does not matter about the default and static method. If that interface contains only one abstract method, then we can say that interface as functional interface. So let me show you whether it is allow us to write another abstract method or not. Okay. Let me add one more abstract method. Let me change the method name to M18. If you go to this error, it is saying invalid functional interface. My functional interface is not a functional interface. The reason, we added two abstract method, right? So if you remove, there will be no compilation error, right? Even this interface, this annotation is not mandatory. If you want, you can add, or else you can remove it, right? So this is what the functional interface. And for functional interface, the method which is abstract, for that only we can write the lambda expression. So we can convert this M1 method to anonymous function using lambda expression. That's what we are going to do. So now let's write the functional interface with abstract method. Then I will explain you how to represent it in lambda expression, right? So let's go to the package. Let me close this class. Let's create a class called calculator IMPL. We'll create the interface of that. So in same, I am creating the interface. Okay. So here, let's add one abstract method, something like void switch on. Okay. So for this abstract method, we are going to write the lambda expression. So as we understood, lambda expression is nothing. We just going to convert this traditional method to anonymous method using lambda expression, right? So let's write a lambda expression for this switch on method. So here, before writing the lambda expression of this switch on method, first we should know the syntax of lambda expression, right? So let me explain you that. Always first we need the parameter, then we need the expression, then we need the method body, right? Add something like body, right? So this is what the syntax of lambda expression. Now let's write the expression. So if in our traditional approach, what we are doing, we are implements from the interface and then we are overriding the method. Then we are creating the main method, and with the reference of parent or child, we are invoking this by providing the implementation, right? So let me write something like sysout switch on. Okay. So this is what our traditional approach, but we are not going to do this way. We are going to write the lambda expression. So how to do it? So let me copy this so that I can explain you easy way. So this is what the syntax we understood. Let's paste this. So as we know, we are going to write the anonymous function with lambda expression, right? So we don't need the method name and prefix, as this is my anonymous function. So you can remove this. So what we understand from the lambda expression, we have the parameter and we have the body. What else we need? We need only the lambda expression, right? So just add that expression. Now this is what my lambda expression of the switch on method. So here it is giving the compilation error. We need to assign it to the corresponding interface, right? So if you observe, this is what my lambda expression of the switch on method. Here we don't need to implement from any interface. Directly you can write, if that interface contains only one method, you can represent in such way with the help of lambda expression. Now if you want to call the method, you can write the reference of interface, then call the method switch on. Let me show you run as Java application. We are able to get the message, right? But we can optimize this method as well. As we have only one statement to print, we don't need the bracket. You can remove that. If only one statement you want to do, that to print, then you can ignore the bracket. So this is what my exact lambda expression of abstract method, that is the switch on, right? So if you observe this line, it have only one line code. But if you go for a traditional approach, which you did previously, you need to implement and you need to override, then provide the business, then again create the object, then call the method. So that's why the advantages of lambda expression, to reduce the code length in my application. Okay, so here, as we have only one method and that is the no argument method, we can easily write the lambda syntax. So let's play with some other kind of method with argument, with return type, then it will be easy for you to understand in all the possible way, right? So let me comment this specific method, and here also let me comment this. We'll write one more method, void add or void sum with one input, int input, right? So as this method don't have any argument, we didn't pass any parameter here, and we are going to write one more method and it have one parameter. How we can write the lambda expression for it? Okay, so let me copy this first. Okay, this is my method. As this is my lambda expression, I want to represent it anonymous function. We don't want method name and prefix, remove it. What else we have? We have only the method parameter. Then if you observe the syntax of lambda, we have the parameter. So what else we need here? We need the expression and body, right? So give the expression then body. This is what your lambda expression of the sum method. So if you want to do something with body, sysout sum, give something like print the same value which we are getting from the method argument, right? And we need to assign it to the interface. Now this is what my lambda expression of sum method. Here as we discussed, we have only one line of statement, so we don't need this bracket. Now even we can optimize it, we don't need to pass the data type of input. That will known to the compiler. As we added the JDK 8 in our build path, that will be identified by compiler which input or what is the data type of your input based on your interface reference, right? So again we optimize it in one line. Now if you want, you can call the method dot sum, give some input. Let's run this application, run as Java application. We are getting the sum 394, as we are printing here the same input which we are passing as method argument, right? So now let's do one more method with return type or with more argument. Okay, so first let me comment this. Let's add one more method with return type and with multiple argument. So let's write it. Let's have the return type int and do the method name subtract, give the input int i1 int i2. Okay, so let me zoom it first. So for this method we are going to write the lambda expression. The method contains return type and have the multiple argument. So let's paste it here. So as this is my anonymous function, we no need the method name and prefix, remove it. And as we understood before, we no need to pass the data type of argument. Let's remove it. So here we have the parameter. What else we need? We need the expression and we need the body, right? So give the expression then body and then assign it to corresponding interface. As this method of the return type, we need to provide the return type here i2 minus i1. Now this is what my lambda expression. So let's call this method subtract, give the input something like 8 and give the 20. So it should return us 12. Let me run this application. Where is the console? Yeah. Run as, sorry, we should print this, right, as the method of the return type. Until unless we will not print, we won't see the result. Now let's run this application. We are able to see the result 12, right? But this syntax also we can optimize, as we have only one line statement. we don't need the bracket here. Let's close it. And as we are going to return in one line, so the ultimately the line is one, so even we don't need the return statement as well. The syntax is look like this, right? So let's run the same, run as Java application. We are getting the result 12, right? But if you have some business logic, you want to perform some logic with those input, you must need to pass the bracket here. So let me show you that. As we are going to do the subtraction, i2 minus i1, so always i2 should be greater than i1, right? So let me show you with some logic. Let's add the bracket and give the semicolon. Now let's write something like if statement, if i2 less than i1, then throw some exception, giving runtime exception. Okay, give some message here if you want. I'm giving some dummy. Else you can return. So if you have some business logic like this, then you must need to add this bracket, or else as we did previously, you just need to remove it and you can place it in a single line. So this is what the advantages of using lambda to reduce the code length. The first advantages is it will reduce the boilerplate code. We no need to write the repeated syntax. Okay, so here what we understand, we just learn the basic syntax, how to write lambda expression in all the possible way, right? So if you know this syntax, what is the exact syntax of lambda, then you can play with lambda. There will be no confusion, right? So let's do some useful example where exactly people are using it in real time or real world example. So let's do one example. Assume you are getting some list of response from the either database or from the third party API call, and you want to return the same data with sorting order. Suppose I am getting list of book object, and based on the book name or based on the page size, I need to sort it and I need to return back to the UI. So in such case, what we can do, we can go for the comparator, right? So let's do the same example, and that we'll do with the help of lambda expression. So let me show you that. I created already book with three field, ID, name and pages. Then I created one DAO layer, dummy DAO, who is return the list of book. Assume this you are getting from database, or else assume you are getting those list of book response from any external REST API call. Now let's write the service of it. Okay, so let's write a method who will return the list of book based on the sorting order, right? So write something like list of book, get books in sort, import the statement util. Now create the object of new book DAO dot get books. It will give the list of book but without any order, right? So let's assign it list of book. We want to sort this list of book based on, assume based on name we are going to sort. Okay, so what we can do, we need to go for the comparator here as we are going to do the custom sorting, right? So for that we can do one thing, we can write one class my comparator. Okay, and we can implement it from comparator interface, then add the type generic book, override the compare method, then here we can write the logic for our sorting. As we are going to sort based on the name, so return one dot get name dot compare to o2.getName, right? So this is how we are doing the sorting, right? And what we can do, we need to pass it to collections.sort. If you observe here, sort is overloaded method having argument list, and another one is list with the comparator for sorting purpose, right? Give it. So list is our books. Then we can pass the object of this my comparator, right? This is what we are doing the traditional approach, but we are not to do the same. We are going to explain it with lambda expression, right? So as of now, let's give the new my comparator. Now if you return the list, it will give the sorting order. Let me show you that. Okay, so let's create a main method, create object of book service dot get books in sort, right? And we want to print it. So I hope I added the toString method in book. No, I didn't add it. Let's add the toString method so that we can print it. Yes, already I added it. Okay, so let's run this application now. We are able to get in sorting order, right? Name core Java, then Hibernate, then Spring, then end is our web services. Now let's just reverse it. This is what we getting the ascending order. Let's do it in descending order. Okay, so o2.getName compared to o2.getName. Save it, then run the same. We are able to get the descending order, first from W, then Spring, then H Hibernate, then the first one is core Java, right? So means our sorting algorithm is working perfectly. So this is what one approach we can do. We can write our own comparator and we can implement the comparator, and that object we can pass here, right? So if you ignore this approach, let me comment this. Okay, so what we can do, we can simply directly pass the comparator here. New comparator, this is what the anonymous, and pass the type generic here, then override the method, right? Here we can add the same logic. Let me copy that. Okay, so let's close this. Yeah, so first one, what we did, we create one separate class for comparator. In second approach, what we did, we write the anonymous implementation of comparator, which is our functional interface, right? So let me run this. You're getting the result, first web services, then Spring, then Hibernate, then core Java, as we are doing the descending. But this approach we don't want. We want it to be represent in lambda expression, right? So okay, so this is what the method for which we are going to write the lambda expression. So that's why let's remove all those stuff here. So what we need to add the lambda expression for method. Let me comment this method so that by seeing this we can easily able to write the syntax. As this is my anonymous method, we don't want any name and prefix, remove it. And as you know, we don't need the pass data type of argument, just remove it. Okay, what else we need the expression, and we have the body, right? As only one statement we are writing here, even you don't need to pass the bracket, right? Now we can pass this instead of comparator. Let's remove this one. Okay, here also you need to remove the return. We did it in one single line, right? This is what my lambda expression. Now if you run this, it is giving me the result in descending. Web services spring, if you change it, O1, O2, it will give us an ascending order. Run it. Now it is giving in ascending order, right? So this is how that comparator is one functional interface, right? So that's why we are able to represent compare method in lambda expression. For other interface we can do like that. Only for functional interface we can represent, right? So this is what we learn about the lambda. You will learn more use case of lambda expression once we will start the example on stream API. So as of now, this is what we covered, the basic syntax of lambda expression, and we covered one use case, how to sort list of data based on a input field using the functional interface comparator, right? So yeah, that's it about this particular video, guys. If anyone have any doubt or concern, you can add a comment. And those who not subscribed yet, please go ahead and subscribe it now. Don't forget to press the bell icon, guys, so that you won't miss any update from Java Techie. And thanks for watching this video.